when they stole my son. Hold on, I'm mad. Oakland Police Department who lied on my son and said that he shot a cop twice. They lied on my son. You got that? They lied. My son never shot a gun. He never shot the cop. And to make shit worse, the cop shot himself in the motherfucking foot. And they killed my son. You think I ain't gonna be mad about it? You think I ain't mad about it? Today is Martin Luther King. We're honoring his legacy. We're honoring his fight. We're honoring the fact that he died because of the color of his skin. Just like my Allen. But fuck that. Ain't no more of that. We gonna stand up and unite and give it back to these punks. They care. Is going to make them win. But we love ourselves and love will outbid hate any day. Yeah. So they can hate me if they want to. But check this out, I love my people. Yeah. I love each and every one of y'all. Find some love in your heart, get with somebody and teach somebody that we can overcome. We ain't gotta march to that fucking shit. We ain't gotta go in there on rules and regulations. Now look at this. They all blocked out. You would think after years, after this man's blood, sweat, and tears, that you would pull over to the side and listen and support. But these cowards are turning around and going the other way. Why? Because they ain't got it in them to stand up and fight. They ain't got it in them to unite. They ain't got it in them to make the change. But guess what? Make the change or we all in the same damn game. How about that? Now I'm pissed off. I am pissed off today. Because I can see it. The media is going around saying that it's black on black. And it's black on brown. And that's where all the problems is coming from. And I'll tell you where the problems is coming from. It's coming from the people in high places. They are putting the leading Republican candidate is a racist.
Yes!
And people are following him and acting like it's the cool shit to do. You better get your legs up your boots and tuck in your shirt, roll up your sleeves and get to work. Because if this punk get in office, we all in trouble. We gotta get somebody and tell somebody that ain't the way. The way is we gonna fight back, bitches. How about that? We gonna get our shit and we gonna take it to y'all. They came in our neighborhood and took my son just because of the color of his skin. Because he was with two other African-American young boys. It's my obligation and my duty to make sure it ain't no more Alex. To make sure it ain't no more Mario. To make sure it ain't no more James. To make sure Josiah can walk across the stage with his PhD and go to the Department of Justice and kick all their ass out. Yeah.
That's right. That's right.
Y'all better wake up, America. This is what we got, but we ain't gotta take it. We can do something else, and the else is this. You better not let that man walk up in there and try to pretend like it's cool for him to be on the ballot. Use your voice now. Yes. If Dr. King's dream means anything, get out and throw his ass out. Woo. It took years to get a holiday. And guess what? They're paying you double time on jobs today if you go to work. That's messed up. But guess what? We ain't forgot. We have not forgotten. I tell you what, I really haven't forgot is all the people I love here that is standing up to say something. But first and foremost are the cowards that ain't saying nothing. They're hiding. They don't want to go out and do the dirty work. They don't want to come out and wrap their arms around the broken-hearted mother. They don't want to make sure that our schools are equipped to teach our kids our own history, not their history. They want to make sure that they can give us a little piece of health care and we all be satisfied. Hell no, it won't go. You understand that? Y'all can look at me. But if you ain't saying hell no, we in trouble. You better say hell no. This won't go. I'm still mad. I just want to say this to you. Yes, I have a dream. I had a dream that I would see my son walk across the stage with his NBA. I had a dream that I would see my grandchildren to look just like him. I had a dream that what I was taught in history class was true, that we are all equal, that we are all the same, that we all have the same rights. But I woke up to a nightmare that wasn't a good dream. That nightmare consists of burying an 18-year-old 2 weeks before he could even walk across the damn high school stage. But guess what? They didn't kill me. They didn't shut me up. They didn't turn me away. They just got upset, but I'm even more mad. So guess what? I want each and every one of you people that are here, do me a favor in honor of us, in honor of that mother whose heart is bleeding over in San Francisco because they shot her baby and he had a mental illness. They want to tell me about an officer who suffered from post-traumatic stress disorder.
We do.
Who shot himself.
We do.
Talk about my post-traumatic stress disorder.
Right.
Talk about when I wake up at night.
That's right.
Talk about my grandson who is 3, who is saying, if I act bad, is the police going to kill me?
Oh.
What are we going to do for him? What are we going to do for him?
Fight.
What are we going to do for him? What are we going to do for him? Fight the motherfucking power.
I'm more fire coming for you. Every time this sister come up and speak, it's fire. She finds for yours. She finds for the finest one. That's my Cindy Mitchell out of Vallejo. Cindy, please come up.